What's cooking, everybody? It's Dor, and in this walkthrough we will be taking a look at the Atlas Path in No Man's Sky. We will be going over all the steps needed to complete it, as well as the rewards you'll get by doing so. And so without any further ado, let's get straight into it. To start the Atlas Path, either warp into a random system containing an Atlas station, or visit the anomaly and ask Specialist Polo for Atlas station coordinates. He will send coordinates to your ship. Just fly into space and open a galaxy map to receive a waypoint. Warp into the system and you'll see your Atlas station floating in space. Fly towards it and enter the Atlas station. Inside the Atlas station, you'll find these glowing orbs. These can learn you new Atlas words, so make sure to collect them all. Once done, head up to the Atlas interface. Make sure to interact with these pillars as well, as they contain free warp cells. There is a lot of warping involved in completing this questline, so the more you can collect, the better. Interact with the Atlas interface to be able to collect your first Atlas seed, the captured nanote. Do note that you will have to complete 5 milestones to be able to collect it. You can easily check how many milestones you've completed at the bottom of the Milestones tab. When you're done, exit the Atlas station and summon the anomaly to stop by Polo again to ask for new directions. You will have to repeat this for a total of 10 times in order to receive all Atlas seeds required to complete the Atlas path. The required amount of milestones you need to receive a new seed at every Atlas interface will increase by 5. To receive the Englobed Shade, you need to have 10 milestones completed. 15 milestones are required to receive the New Spheric Orb, 20 milestones for Dark Matter, 25 for Dawn's End, 30 to receive Photic Jade, 35 for State Phasure, 40 milestones for Novia Reclaimant, 45 for Modified Quanta, and finally 50 to receive the Blueprint for the Heart of the Sun. You will need to craft the Heart of the Sun in order to complete the Atlas path. In order to craft the Heart of the Sun, you will need to craft all the previously unlocked Atlas seeds first, beginning with the captured nanote. Do so, and when you've crafted the Heart of the Sun, once again head up to Polo to ask for Atlas station coordinates one more time. Warp into the system and enter the Atlas station. You'll notice that this time the station does not have any glowing orbs and the path towards the Atlas interface has changed. Walk up to the interface and interact with the first Atlas seed chamber on the left. Go by them all in a clockwise manner. While we're doing so, I want to ask you to please leave a like and or comment if you found this video helpful in any way. And don't forget to subscribe to be informed on all things No Man's Sky, from beginner's guides to amazing starships and anything in between. When you're done, interact with the Unity of the Shnun in the middle, at the cost of the Heart of the Sun. You'll get the option to birth a new star or to just walk away. Pick birth a new star, as this option will reward you with the star seed. To fully complete the Atlas path, reselect it in the missions log. A route towards a black hole will be plotted on your galaxy map. Warp towards the system, as you will need to go through the black hole. Black holes damage a random installed technology module in your Starship's general inventory. So either move all your installed modules into your Starship's technology slots, or summon your freighter in the system to swap to a secondary Starship. For me, that's the Radiant Pillar, which I also use to complete the purge in the main storyline and already has a lot of broken technology because of it. Go through the black hole to be warped closer towards that galaxy's core and to fully complete the Atlas path. The rewards unlocked by completing this somewhat repetitive quest are quite okay. First, you will have black holes permanently marked on your galaxy map, making travel towards the galaxy's core that much easier. Next to this, installing the starseed for 16 platinum, 16 tritium, and 16 gold will grant you an extra core health. Crafting another Heart of the Sun will also let you install the Remembrance, unlocked by completing the purge. This also costs 16 platinum and adds yet another core health to your exosuit. So, do you think having black holes marked on your galaxy's map is worth doing the Atlas path? Let me know in the comments down below and I'll hopefully see you in the next video. Thank you so much for making it this far into the video. If you liked it, make sure to leave a thumbs up and let me know in the comments down below. If you really did, please subscribe. And if not, well, I hope I get to convince you in the next video.